हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम सारिका राय शर्मा, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, स्कूल ऑफ एजुकेशन, महात्मा गांधी अंतर्राष्ट्रीय हिंदी विश्वविद्यालय, वर्धा, महाराष्ट्र. टुडे वी विल ट्राई टू कॉम्प्रिहेंड द टॉपिक अंडरस्टैंडिंग द लर्नर. बट बिफोर वी स्टार्ट आवर टॉपिक, इट इज नेसेसरी फॉर यू टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाई इज इट एट ऑल इम्पॉर्टेंट टू अंडरस्टैंड द लर्नर. बिकॉज द लर्नर्स इन योर क्लास कम फ्रॉम diverse socio-economic and cultural backgrounds. So, it is necessary for a teacher to understand how different socio-political realities construct different childhoods within the children's lived contexts. This presentation will not only help you to understand your learners, but it will also guide you in proper planning and implementation of the pedagogy and curriculum to realize the all-round development of your learners. Therefore, after going through this presentation, you will be able to understand the socio-cultural and socio-economic factors that have an influence on the learning and development of your learners. You will also be able to recognize the psychosocial factors that have an influence on the process of development and learning among your learners. We will also discuss the role of media and technology in these processes. So, let's begin with our discussion on this topic. As you are aware, humans do not develop or function in a vacuum. Therefore, there is a reciprocal interaction between each individual and their environment that constitutes the physical conditions, cultural influences, interpersonal relations, psychological climate, that must be studied carefully in order to understand the learner. In 1994, Yuri Bronfman Brenner developed the ecological models of human development in order to understand the development of an individual within the context of the system of relationships that form his or her immediate surrounding. According to his theory, an individual's development and personality are affected by these settings and also by the larger context in which the settings are embedded. Here is the model given by Bronfman Brenner. Bronfman Brenner's ecological model was comprised of five socially organized subsystems, namely microsystem, mesosystem, exosystem, and the macrosystem. However, there is a fifth component known as the chronosystem that we will discuss in the coming slides. The microsystem. A microsystem refers to the relationship between the individual and the immediate environment, such as family, school, peers, etc. An individual comes into direct contact and interaction with the structures present in this particular system. The nature of relationships is bidirectional in nature, that is, the structures and the individual both influence each other. It has the strongest influence on an individual, since it comes in the immediate surrounding of the individual. A microsystem is a pattern of activities, social roles, and interpersonal relations experienced by the developing person in a given face-to-face setting. So, this invites, permits, or inhibits engagement in complex interaction and activity in the immediate environment. If we can say in simple terms, a child learns to behave with his or her parents, siblings, neighbors, and teachers based on the experiences that has been earned by him or her during the socialization process. How the components, that is family, society, neighbor, peers in the microsystem interact with each other and the individual constitutes the next system, that is the mesosystem. The mesosystem refers to the linkages and interactions between the structures of an individual's microsystem. For example, the nature of relationship between a child's family and the neighbors, or the nature of interaction between a child's parents and the school. It acts as a system of microsystem. The exosystem constitutes the third subsystem. It refers to the larger social system. The structures present in the exosystem are filtered to the individual through the structures present in the microsystem. They do not interact directly with the individual. They influence the structures and the processes in the microsystem and thus have an impact, indirect impact, on the individual. For example, a child does not interact with the parent's workplace directly, but it has an influence on the child through the parent. Suppose if your father's salary has got a raise or your mother has got promotion at her workplace, will it not affect your lifestyle? Think about it. The three most important exosystems that have more influence are parents' workplace, family's social network, neighborhood, and neighborhood community context. Macrosystem. The macrosystem refers to the institutional patterns of culture, such as the economy, customs, values, and laws. This represents the outermost layer in an individual's environment. The structures present in the macrosystem do not influence an individual directly, but through the interaction of the other systems or layers present in an individual's environment. It affects an individual placed in a national context through the political and economical policies and provisions. For example, right to education or midday meal scheme is not meant for a particular individual. They were not implemented for a particular individual, but it is implemented at a national level and it has an influence on the land. Coming to the fifth system, the chronosystem, that you were not able to see in the diagram given in the earlier slides. The chronosystem consists of the changes or consistency in the individual and his or her environment over time. For example, changes in the family structure, socioeconomic status, place of residence, etc., with time also have an influence on the individual. Therefore, the system encompasses the dimension of time with respect to an individual's environment. Now that we are aware of the Bronfenbrenner's ecological model, we will discuss the factors that influence a learner or a student. These factors can be categorized as sociocultural factors, socioeconomic factors, psychosocial factors, and technological factors. In the coming slides, we will be discussing these factors in detail. However, you will see some factors will be overlapping because of the nature of those components. Sociocultural factors. The sociocultural factors are the forces that help us to understand learners' behavior and personality development by examining the norms and culture of the social groups and subgroups in which he or she is a member. The sociocultural factors are religion, gender, social class, caste, language, region, beliefs, values, customs, and traditions. The agents of sociocultural factors are family, school, peer groups, and community. The parenting style, family structure, the relationship between parents, etc., have an influence on the development of self, identity, personality, life skills, emotions, language, etc. in the learner. As we know, the parenting style can differ from authoritarian to democratic or laissez-faire. The family structure can be a joint family or single parent family. The relationship between parents can be cordial or conflict-ridden. All these factors have an influence on the development of identity and self among the learners. The family plays a central role in the healthy development of children. But as children grow older, other influences become increasingly important. The school is the most important of these influences. The school is a social system in which children learn rules of morality, social conventions, attitudes, and modes of relating to others. It is a social institution reflecting the culture of which it is a part and transmitting to the young an ethos and a worldview. Therefore, the school infrastructure and ethos, teachers' attitude towards the learners, principal's leadership style, curriculum and its implementation, and school reputation affect the development of identity, belongingness, self-esteem, security, recognition, creativity, higher cognitive needs, opinions and aspirations among learners. Coming to the socioeconomic factors. Socioeconomic factors are associated with the status ascribed to the learner's family within a social group that is usually based on the parents' income, educational attainments, and occupation. It determines the finances available with the parents to invest in their children and the quality of life attributes afforded by the learner's family, the basic amenities afforded by the family. The socioeconomic status can be categorized as upper class, middle class, and lower class. What are the effects of socioeconomic factors? It influences the health, cognitive, and socio-emotional aspects in the learner, with effects beginning prior to birth and continuing into adulthood. Families in poverty have less access to good prenatal and infant health care and nutrition. Poor health care for mother and child, limited resources, family stress, interruption in schooling, exposure to violence, overcrowding, homelessness, discrimination, and other factors lead to school failures and low-paying jobs. The variation in the educational opportunities as a result of differing socioeconomic status has an influence on the personality of the learner that may offer an explanation for social immobility. Researchers have shown that negative psychological health is linked to lower socioeconomic status, whereas higher socioeconomic status helps in the development of self-esteem, patience, optimism, and perceived control among learners. Lower socioeconomic status is also associated with high levels of emotional and behavioral difficulties, including social problems, delinquent behavior symptoms, learned helplessness, resistant culture, attention deficit, hyperactivity disorders, high rates of depression, anxiety, attempted suicide, drug abuse, and episodic heavy drinking in extreme cases. Lower socioeconomic status students means learners belonging to the lower socioeconomic status or any student who is failing continually may come to believe that doing well in school is impossible. Many of their friends and relatives never finish schooling. Therefore, it seems normal to quit. This is known as learned helplessness. Whereas the resistant cultures among learners refers to group values and beliefs about refusing to adopt the behaviors and activities of the majority culture. In this particular case, this majority culture is the learners belonging to the higher socioeconomic status. The higher infant mortality, decreased educational success, have a lasting impact on learning in terms of language, cognition, and socio-emotional skills, behavior, and health. The third factor is the psychosocial factor. The psychosocial factors describe the relation between the learner's emotional needs and his/her social environment. It includes social support, social status, social integration, disruption, school environment, home environment, parenting style, family structure, etc. These factors act upon the learner's mental and emotional state through the social processes and social structures in which he or she is situated. Stanfield and Russell has explained that the effect of social processes are sometimes mediated through psychological understanding. Social factors include general factors at the level of an individual society,
concerned with social structures and processes that impinge on the individuals. Whereas the psychological factors include individual level processes and meanings that influence mental states. Effects of psychosocial factors. The psychosocial factors affect a learner's self-control, self-confidence, self-concept, interpersonal relations, perseverance, autonomy, values, ideology, motivation, aspirations, decision-making, skill, coping and social skills. For example, the parents should be protective but not overprotective, because if parents don't let the child make efforts to master basic motor and cognitive skills during childhood, he or she may begin to doubt her own abilities. Similarly, the teachers must provide various opportunities to the learners in order to let them explore their interest areas and competencies. It determines the process of development of identity and self among the learners. Erik Erikson has proposed a theory of psychosocial development that we will discuss in a separate presentation, or you can refer to the book given in the reference section. The last that we will be discussing in today's presentation are the technological factors. The technological factors include print media, broadcast media, internet, mobile phones, social media, etc. Technological factors, especially the social media, create a virtual world for the learners. The media is often blamed for many psychological problems. But technology in itself is neither good nor bad. It is neutral. It's we who make it a boon or a bane. Like, a matches stick can be used to light a house or it can be used to burn a house. Therefore, technology is just like a matches stick. The lack of accessibility or unavailability to technology is also a factor that affects the learner, because technology has also become a status symbol. The technological factors, especially media, acts as a source of recreation, socialization, enculturation, education, constructive engagement, perspective building, development of communication skills, global identity, etc. For example, as we can see in this COVID situation, in this pandemic situation, teachers are using technology for educational purposes, for taking online classes. Also, it acts as a means of, as a source of enculturation. It makes us understand the culture of other people and as well as the culture in which we are growing up. It also helps in perspective building by getting into touch with many ideologies, many aspects of an issue. However, the negative impact of technology is associated with addictive behavior, sleep deprivation, eating disorders, decreased attention span, low self-esteem, depression, loneliness, social isolation, threat to privacy, obesity, aggression, promoted consumerism, etc. We see that many students and many people complain that they can't live without their mobile, or they are usually or continually gazing into the mobile screen. All these things also lead to certain health problems like vision, audio, etc. So friends, in today's presentation, we got to know the Bronfman-Banner's ecological model as well as the various factors that affect a learner. I hope this will help you understand your learners in their situated reality. However, if you wish to go through some additional material, here are the references for your help. Thank you very much.